He meets Emily Blunt's character, and the plan says that they're not supposed to be together. So, you know, I'm put in a position where I have to try and keep them apart, but they just keep running into each other. They keep rehashing this relationship that isn't supposed to be. So she takes away from who he is, who he's going to be, who he's supposed to be, in the lines of the plan. So that being said, if he's supposed to end up here, but when he meets her, he goes there, it's my job to intersect that moment and get him to here. Well, the great thing about George writing and directing this project is he knows exactly what he wants. He knows exactly the story he wants to tell. He knows exactly the shots he wants to tell that story. I feel a lot of times between the writer and a director, you can lose a bit of the moral of the story in a way, because the writer might have meant one thing and the director means something completely different by the picture that they're making. But the thing with George, from the first day, he realized the movie that he wanted to make, and that's the picture that he sold to everybody that's involved, including Matt, and all the way down the line to the last guy on the call sheet. And it's a huge advantage to be able to talk to him about character, talk to him about plot-driven aspects of your character, and him have intelligent answers because he wrote the script and came up with the idea off of a short story. When people go check out Adjustment Bureau, you're gonna have everything you could possibly want out of a film. You're going to have very good performances. You're going to have a creative, unconventional script. You're going to have beautiful cinematography, and it's going to come together and make a quality film. Like, I feel like a lot of times we go to the movies and we see movies, but I think with this, you can sit back, eat your popcorn, and really enjoy a smart, thought-provoking film.